Greetings. I recently made a video about reason 6 to reject Islam. Allah lied. It has had more viewing than most, and as I expected, none of the comments deal with the basic problem. Allah lied. One comment was made that is interesting to consider in a video of its own. God appeared to Moses in the form of a burning bush. Does that mean that God deceived Moses? Your same logic applies. That answer is no, because God is the truth. It is your logic that is at fault, not God. I'd like to analyze this response so that you understand how the mind of a Mohammedan works or doesn't work. Let me first summarize and clarify the point this Mohammedan is attempting to make. God appeared as a burning bush to Moses, but God is not really a burning bush. So God's changing his appearance was not an act of deception. Therefore, Allah changing the appearance of the crucifixion is also not a deception, right? That is exactly the logic the Mohammedan is trying to claim is correct. Keep in mind, the challenge is to always accurately represent the claims Islam makes. So when you crush their argument, it is irrefutable and unmistakable. God appeared to Moses in the form of a burning bush. Does that mean that God deceived Moses? Your same logic applies. The answer is no, because God is the truth. It is your logic that is at fault, not God. Let's look at these one by one. God appeared to Moses in the form of a burning bush. In your discussions with Mohammedans, you must realize that context means nothing to them. And I would remind you, they are free to say anything in one context, but not consistently apply the same comment in any other. This is a great example of one such fact that will be tossed out with the Mohammedan never ever thinking what it implies. God appeared to Moses in the form of a burning bush. Think about that. God appeared to Moses. God entered his creation and appeared to Moses. God talked to Moses. Mohammedans claim God cannot enter his creation. Mohammedans think God could not enter his creation as Jesus. God could not enter his creation and talk to men directly. But the word of God does not say, "And God gave Moses a dream," or "Moses had a vision." The word of God, revealed by Moses, says that God appeared to Moses. And if anyone knows, it was Moses. Does that mean that God deceived Moses? It actually depends on what you think the purpose of God appearing was about. I suppose if you think God was trying to make people think he was a bush, a shrubbery, then you might be willing to try to foolishly argue that claim as a serious point. But that doesn't make much sense when you ask the question, why? Does it? God spoke and the message was heard. But in the case of Jesus on the cross, Muhammad claims it wasn't Jesus. So not one word spoken by the apparition people thought was Jesus was a message from a prophet. And not to get distracted and derailed, but Mohammedans cannot even decide if Jesus was hung on the cross or not. And they twist the definition of crucifixion as they argue with themselves. Your same logic applies. Let's take two separate events and allege that both events were simply an appearance of the events. Can the two appearances be critically compared? Sure. You just need to be consistent in the logic you apply. You might want to ask, what was the purpose of the two events? You might want to ask, what is the evidence to claim it is only an appearance? You might want to ask, why the appearance but not the real event? You might want to ask, does it, being only an appearance, change the meaning of the event? Are the two events even of the same type of activity? What was the purpose of the two events? The purpose of the burning bush was so that God could be in close physical proximity to Moses and speak to him directly. The purpose of Jesus being crucified was to fulfill the law and the prophets, for God to be the Redeemer of mankind as he had promised for 2,000 years. What is the evidence to claim it is only an appearance? The evidence we have of God appearing as a burning bush is Moses' record of the event, which is his testimony that Moses spoke with God and God was in the burning bush. It is faithfully recorded and preserved in the Torah, which even Mohammed bowed down to beg for credentials. There is no evidence that the crucifixion was only an appearance as such. We have only a baseless claim, a conjecture, made 600 years later, 1,000 miles away, in a language and culture that was ignorant of history. So in the first case, we have the first-hand eyewitness testimony of Moses, the prophet of the Most High God, who even Mohammedans claim to respect. But in the second case, as stated, we only have hearsay, baseless claims, foundationless conjecture from someone who was not even a prophet of God. I think that is a glaring difference, proving the two situations are not similar in the least. Why the appearance but not the real event? First, pay attention to the fact that God was with Moses. It was only the appearance that Moses saw which looked like a burning bush. And even though the appearance was in one form, it was undeniable to Moses and to all who respect the Word of God that God was there and God did speak to Moses. Contrast that with the claim Jesus only appeared to be crucified. Mohammed's claim is that Jesus was not even there. Jesus had escaped. He was gone. So Mohammed's claim of the appearance is so that Jesus could fool, fake, and deceive those who wanted to hurt him. This was Allah's way to save Jesus. And in making the claim of the crucifixion, being only an appearance of such, Mohammed calls all the statements made by Jesus on the cross auditory hallucinations or tricks. And the only reason Mohammedans can come up with was to save Jesus? But none of them consider, why wouldn't God raise Jesus up in public, in plain view, in full sight of the Jews and the Romans? How mighty would God be on that day? How much fear would that cause in the Jews and the infidels? Allah kind of screwed the pooch on this one, missed the biggest chance to show just what kind of Allah he was. There literally is no good reason or rationale Mohammedans can give why Allah was impotent to make a public appearance and had to secretly hide Jesus escaping. Does it, being only an appearance, change the meaning of the event? In the case of the burning bush, not in the least. Moses knew God was present, and God spoke, and Moses heard and received the message from God. But by the author of the Quran making the claim that the crucifixion was only an appearance of such, they hope to imply that the foundation of Christianity was false, that God's act of redemption had never happened, that the symbolic Passover lamb had not been literally fulfilled, that the sins of mankind had not been washed by the blood of the lamb, that Satan's defeat by the crucified Lord had never happened. And now, perhaps for a moment, you can finally grasp the motive. for the entire claim, the entire message of Muhammad, the entire religion of Islam. Let that sink in. Are the two events even in the same type of activity? Not in any way. From the burning bush, God was directly giving Moses a message, a revelation, and God performed signs to verify the message. The crucifixion was literally the fulfillment of God's plan since before the creation of the world. There is simply no way in this universe that God is going to fake that. The God of Abraham is not a mere poser and pretender to the throne. God does not thump his chest with empty words as the Allah of Muhammad does. Your same logic applies. In fact, the same logic does not apply. In the case of Islam's tale, the only rationale consistently offered was to save Jesus from death. So Islam talks about how Jesus benefited and was protected, as if the point of God sending prophets was to keep them safe and not let them get hurt, like we see in the history of Israel and the treatment of the various prophets. Matthew 23:31, "Wherefore you be witnesses unto yourselves, that you are the children of them which killed the prophets." Luke 11:47, "Woe unto you, for you build sepulchres of the prophets, and your fathers killed them." Romans 11:3, "Lord, they have killed thy prophets, and digged thine altars, and I am left alone, and they seek my life." So it seems that Islam's comprehension of the fate of the prophets does not grasp the true history of their purpose and fate. To rationalize God saved Jesus and spared him from a painful death shows no understanding of history. And this is a fundamental problem that you should have with Islam. When they make up excuses to defend Islam, they don't ever apply coherent, consistent, logical thought, let alone knowledge of history. It is completely obvious they never even ask themselves the first question: does what I am about to claim even make sense? God appeared to Moses in the form of a burning bush. Does that mean that God deceived Moses? Your same logic applies. As we have seen, the logic is different because the situations are different. That answer is no, because God is the truth. It is your logic that is at fault, not God. He is saying, no, God did not deceive Moses, but it is a backwards claim based on God being truth. God is the truth, so God cannot lie, therefore God does not deceive. This is a fairly typical example of Mohammedan logical deduction. Side note, he can claim God is truth, but Mohammedans forever ignore that Jesus said, "I am the truth," which means Jesus claimed to be God. So consider again that Mohammedism was created by someone or something simply to attack, deny, refute, and subvert the gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ, which is founded, established, and verified by Jesus' crucifixion and death on the cross, and his subsequent burial and resurrection from the dead. Satan could not defeat the Lord Jesus, so his only hope is to attempt to rewrite history and blind the eyes of men with the web of lies called Islam. That is the whole reason why Satan had to include Surah 4:157 in the text of his Quran. That is why Muhammad had to claim Allah lied to all of mankind for 600 years. It is simply to advance the greater cause of Islam. But Satan does not care what you call him. Curse words, Satan the dog, or even Allah, as long as he can trick you into going to hell. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.